As water levels run low, tensions are riding high between state and federal ministers over the country's drought crisis. The future of the Murray-Darling Basin plan hangs in the balance, with New South Wales threatening to walk away.
Entire towns running out of water, millions of fish dying, farmers going broke. And the government agreement to provide more water for the environment is leaving the Murray-Darling Basin plan on the brink of collapse.
If the future of this plan is reliant on New South Wales finding those savings, well then you know what, we will have to walk away from the plan.
The states had agreed to find an additional 450 gigalitres to give the river system a drink, roughly the same amount of water as Sydney Harbour. But now in the midst of this shocking drought, New South Wales and Victoria say they need that water for towns and farms. And they want South Australia to do more, like run the desalination plant in Adelaide to full capacity and pump water into the Murray River.
South Australia's not meeting the published commitments.
Melinda Pavey is a new minister and I think she's got a lot to learn.
The federal government is fighting to keep the plan afloat.
What we need is maturity and leadership. We're sick of the squabbles.
But if commitments aren't kept, the minister will have to forcibly buy water from farmers.
Buybacks are blunt instruments we do not want, but by law, that is where I'm bound.
If that's the ultimatum by South Australia and the Feds, well, more than likely we'll walk away from the plan.
The states did discuss how drought affects the plan, but did not commit to making any changes. They will, however, appoint an Inspector General whose sole job it is to enforce the law across the entire Murray-Darling.
That job has fallen, for now at least, to former AFP Commissioner Mick Kelty. Chris O'Keefe, Nine News.